Discretion is advised.
Happy Monday. You are listening and or watching Pwncast. This is episode 120. Holy crap. 120. We are in patch 7.0.3. Tonight we are going to be talking about what else? Demon Hunters going live on Tuesday. Demon Invasions. I don't know if anybody heard, but a man gets arrested and charged with threatening Blizzard and some players in game. We're going to talk about that. We have PvP carries and win trading gets a nice little hammer in World of Warcraft life. So we have that and much, much more. So make sure you guys stay right here.
In the World of Warcraft trade chat, troll-based offenses are considered especially heinous. In Azeroth, the dedicated players who call out these asshats are members of the elite squad known as the Pwncast Podcast. These are their story.
Welcome back. It is that time again. I hate that Jimma knows the stuff I'm going to say. I guess I have to decide if I'm going to unmute these guys, which I guess I should. Maybe? Question mark? I don't know. That beanie's pretty epic. I guess I'm going to go ahead and unmute them now. There. You guys are unmuted. I did bring the Riders of Rohan with me. I did bring the shaman who had Bell seeing double by meeting his brother, who I have dubbed the Amish bloke. Huge bloke.
We look nothing alike. At all.
Except I thought it was you sitting at your desk with a beard on. So I literally was like, wow, that's a nice beard, bloke. And then it was brought to my attention that it was not in
fact. In all honesty, that's why I've gone and shaved mine down, is so that we look further apart. No, I tell people all the time, like, I'm a little fatter, he's got a better beard. That's about the only difference between us.
And he looks super Amish.
Oh, yeah.
Churn and butter, horse and buggy, like.
Well, that's why he had no idea how to use the interwebs and say hello to you.
Annie has a really hot wife, though. They're married, right? That's the. Didn't you have a wedding? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm sorry. All the wives are just across the board, just hot. I can't even. I mean, I'm straight, but just saying.
Even Jimma's. She's beautiful.
Just throwing it out there.
Yeah. No. She's hot. I did also bring the monk whose enveloping mist causes people to have the munchies.
Damn.
The first accurate intro. I'm going to go with Aja on that one. Thanks, Aja. I can see Belle coming up with that as well, but everyone is innocent until proven guilty. And
everyone's guilty until proven innocent, bro.
Valid.
This is true. I may go visit Hots for Shots at his new location.
You're gonna make me
do it.
Be all super
for no particular reason.
Oh yeah, everyone knows, right? But
not yet. Or, I mean, I was actually gonna mention that after.
I stole your segment. You moving did. On to secret sauce. Her
Isle of Thunder.
I did also bring the priest whose desperate prayer is really that his woman never goes through his closet and finds out that he secretly wants to be a female. Secret sauce.
The hell?
You're really
pretty,
so it's not that far off, to be honest.
All my nice clothes are still at my mom's, so these are all my work clothes here. So all my dress clothes back home, and that's a whole lot of, like, I don't know, 50 different color work shirts. So, yeah, do it.
Our artist is working on your art right now, and he said, so should I do a hat for Sauce as well? And I'm like, no, he's too pretty because his hair is always on point, so you have to highlight that.
It's growing again, so, like, right here, so that's why the hats are going to start coming back on, so.
To be honest, that's why I'm wearing a beanie. I don't want everyone to see what's going on under here.
I could have did it. That's too much time.
It's pretty bad.
I was running late. I wanted to make sure I was on time for the show.
Gamers are lazy by nature, though, so I think it's not without reason that you have messy hair. I don't have pants on 90% of the time, so.
I just woke up. I slept until the show, right?
So. I'm pretty sure Bloke also doesn't have pants on, so.
He probably doesn't.
Yeah, he doesn't wear pants ever.
There you go.
Yeah, the awkward smile says it all. So we have a lot to talk about as far as just like randomness in World of Warcraft, but I did want to let you guys know, for those of you that have been listening and watching for the length of time we have been doing this, that Hots for Shots, who did live with me for just over a year, has flown the nest of Mama Belle and is now on his way on a plane right now to Colorado, where he's going to be living in the team house for Colorado Clutch. And he had to leave everything behind, literally, including his computer. They wouldn't let him take his box on the plane because the dimensions were wrong. So we have his computer. We have all of his things. It's actually quite tragic. But yeah, I literally, my whole desk is filled with his crap because he's like, hey, do you want this? Hey, do you want this? Hey, do you want this? And this is now adding to my ever-growing collection of desks that when people move in and live with me, they move out and leave their desks. So
can I have it? Can I have one?
You need it, actually.
Just ship that. I'm sure shipping and handling won't cost much.
No,
just about $200.
So it's super heavy because it's glass. So
I'll just walk and pick it up.
Yeah, I went in his room earlier and it's all sad and
it's all sad and depressing
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it's all sad.
So business as usual.
My kids have been calling dibs on his shit for a week. Literally, like, oh, they keep my going God. In his room trying to call dibs on his stuff, and it makes.
Doesn't that sound familiar, Bill? Sounds like old days right there for us.
I know. Right?
Let me get them sneakers.
That's actually pretty valid. Let me get your fan.
Oh my gosh.
Well, that Annie probably had a bunch of dresses and women's clothes in there from his.
Probably did.
And fairy tails and spiky ears.
You know, he took the tail. He was not going to leave that tail behind, guys. That's just not.
I seen a really cool tail at work. I'm not going to talk about it on the show, but I probably will buy it and send it to Hots. He might enjoy it.
It's awkward. I'm
intrigued, but I don't want to ask.
This week, we talked about the camera zoom, right? They made it where they messed up the camera zoom. They made it where you could go too far. Like, everybody kind of had complaints about the camera zoom. They are adjusting that and fixing. They basically took to the forums, and there was a post that was made by Watcher, which is Ian Hazakostas. He made a post about how they were apologizing that people were uncomfortable with the new camera zoom and all that stuff. So it is going to be adjusted and fixed for everybody's viewing pleasure. I personally didn't really care one way or the other. It didn't really affect me, but there were a lot of people that were bothered by it, including the issue with a lot of people getting motion sickness, which...
That's a thing.
Well, I have had that happen. I've seen it. On somebody's two-person mount, and they were acting like a dick, and they would, like... Remedy, for instance, being on his two-person mount when we were doing the demon invasions, he would like spiral down, being at the top of the air and go all the way down, and it would legit make me sick. So, yeah, but yeah, that's pretty much my story of Remedy. I can't tell if you guys are frozen or if Skype is frozen or
no. We're waiting for you to continue. We're good. Carry on,
nobody's
boss.
Nobody's going to interrupt me.
I was being polite for once. Yeah. You told me off and I had to use my manners and stuff, and then I do it, and now you're just being a bitch about it.
I've learned to pause to allow you guys to interrupt, and nobody interrupted during my pause. Well, then.
I'm going
to
be honest. I zoned out and forgot what we were talking about.
I was talking in chat, so, and I muted my mic. So.
You following all the rules this week?
Today, yes.
The one day they choose to all follow the rules.
Hey.
Literally the one day.
Fucking hey, give us a break.
But at least we all followed them together.
Yes.
Yeah.
See, we're working as a team.
Yeah. All right, everybody. She scolds us like 10 minutes after the show if we don't do what she says correctly. So we were trying to learn how to, you know,
hold on.
Smooth out
when
the plane.
When you say scold, I'm not really sure what you mean here because there's no scolding.
I don't know, but it sounds hot.
So... Blizzard posted over the week that they were disqualifying people that had made it to the BlizzCon is going to be the finals. They still have like one more set of qualifiers or finals before the actual finals. I think that's going to be in October. So people that were engaging in win trading and carries for the PvP ladders for Warlord Season 3. So essentially what they've said here is if you took part in this or you did this, they've for win trading and people logging on to other people's accounts to get them, you know, high ranking on the ladder, they've actually made it where they don't get any rewards for Warlord Season 3. Still don't know about the title though, so I'm waiting to see more information on that because I think it should stand to reason that they shouldn't get the title or the achievements. If you're going to not allow them the rewards. I think hopefully that included the title and really the ladder ranking too, because there were people that would have been knocked out from that ladder in PvP if you were engaging in selling carries. Now, please keep in mind that as far as the carries are concerned, there are people that sell them for real life money. Although it's not illegal, I don't think, in the WoW technical sense, question mark. I'm not really sure. I know it's illegal for tournaments. And
you mean like for them to pay and have a, that's like a better player boost
to take my SATs.
Yeah, like paying for somebody to carry you in real life money, they're not having control of your character. So I don't really know. There are people that do the win trading and they do the here's my account, log on and get me this high ladder when it wasn't them that played. And of course, how they track that is via IPs. They watch the nature of the IPs that log into Battle.net and stuff like that. That's pretty easily trackable. And it could stand to reason that, say, somebody in New York, if they're every once in a while logging onto your account and just doing PvP, then I guess we can all know what that means. Now, there's a lot of debate in the community as to whether or not this is valid. Some players on that made it to BlizzCon's through the qualifiers, actually, those players are going to have to be replaced on their roster. If they can't find a replacement, they're burnt on going to the finals.
Yeah, tough titty.
That's a lot of money that people have put on the line for doing dumb shit. Now, we all know how Pwncast stands as far as what we feel is cheating, but I think that it's one of those moments where, so I see constantly in trade chat people advertising to sell carries for gold or people looking to buy carries for gold. I know several people who do both gold and real life money, and I it's one of those things where it's a gray area where I don't want to judge people, but at the same time, I wouldn't partake in those type of activities because I feel like my name shouldn't be on a ladder and I shouldn't get those kind of things.
Well, yeah, people have to get over getting an extra 300 ranking or however much they're being brought up, but they're also bumping down X amount of people as well. So it's just, it's bad all around.
Now, there's the offset to that where people charge for, they were charging for the Moose Mount, they charge for Archmon Mythic, they charge for freaking
full challenge players. Modes, you know, everything.
They charge
yeah.
for those things.
But I went to one of those sites and it's interesting.
Well, and I think the difference when people have said, I've seen some comments on Facebook when we posted the article on PDQ, people were like, well, what's the difference in raid carries? Valid, because I got carried for my Moose. So I think it's one of those things where because the ladders say something to somebody, right? When you look at the ladders, you're like, really, wow, that guy's badass. Different. Yeah, because then you're physically knocking people down that might have otherwise earned it in the righteous way versus somebody that actually paid for it. And I think that's really what the difference is here. I think if there was like a raid ladder, I think that would matter. But because there isn't, there's just the achievement essentially that you're buying when you're buying something like that, I think it's just, and even paying real life money, I don't knock people for making gold in game because I think people need to have a way to be able to make gold. And I know that some of these guys that did these arena carries do it as a means to make gold. And I don't knock that because the raiders do it. I have a problem with real money. I'm not going to lie. I have a problem with that interaction per se, because I think that's a way of cheating the system and a means for you to be able to make money. I know it kind of sounds weird because it's like, well, what's the difference between gold and real money? Ethically speaking, I think
in game gold, I mean, you're only going to spend it in game. Like, that's it.
Right. I'm basically
real money. I'm going to go buy a pair of new Nikes.
I'm paying you to put me on the top of the ladder so that you could go buy sneakers, essentially, is what's happening here. And PvP to a lot of people is serious. It means something to people. Seeing their name on the ladders, that matters. That means something to people. When you take that away because you paid for it, why do it at all? Because you want to say you have this great rating? To me, to have a good rating in PvP is because I did it. That's where the value is for me. It's not the value that I log in and see the number. The value is that I did it. I don't know that I would be comfortable bragging like, oh, my rating's 2K. Well, you paid for that rating, so.
Yeah, I think they want the achievement mount. Go ahead, Blue.
In regards to PvP, like, I have no issues with paying for in-game across the board, be it the Moose Mount raids, challenge modes, PvP, arena matches, like anything like that. Pay for it in game, yeah, no worries. If you're stupid enough to want to actually spend real life currency on it, then go right ahead. Like, I don't know about anybody else, but I spent the last year and a half paying for my game with in game currency.
No, mine's free. I don't pay for it.
Because I don't want to spend, you know, the $20 dues a month to pay for the game subs. Like, I'm trying to find ways to not spend real world money on it. Like, that's me personally. So I wouldn't go and do it. Like, I think if you're dumb enough to go and do it and then get a call, then, you know, where are the consequences? But in terms of using in-game currency and getting carried actually in the game, so you're retaining control of your account, and, you know, you're just standing back while, like, say in threes, you stand back while the other two go hard at it and do the bit, and you get your vicious wall saddle or whatever it is. I got no issues with that, because, shit, if I had more time, I probably would have done it that way myself just to get it. Sure. But there's no way in fuck I'd drop $100 to give someone else my account. No way. I don't even give the password to my kids. Like, my kids, we have a merged account. I don't give the password to him. I don't give a fuck if I'm 20 minutes away from my house. I'm like, no, sorry, son, you're going to have to wait. I drive home, put the password in myself, and then go back out. I'm like, yeah, no way, man. You don't get my account for nothing.
For gold purposes, buying and selling carries, somebody made a good point, and they were like, well, how are PvPers supposed to make their money? Here's the thing. Segregating PvPers from PvEers, there's lots of ways that PvPers can make their money and not sell things that are ethically in question, okay? So I totally get it. PvPers need to have a way to make their money. Raid guilds, they sell their carries. I'm not knocking it. I think that's great. That's awesome for them. The guild makes money. The guildies make money. This is commerce, guys. This is commerce at its best, and this is what we've always had in World of Warcraft. It's trading and bartering. However... Yep. Like, it's different than me saying, hey, Sauce, can you carry me in arena so that I can get capped out? Versus me saying,
I sure can't, because I don't PvP.
Versus me saying, I'm going to pay you $200 in real life money to get me X amount of rating.
Now, dude, I would totally do it then.
I think that begs the question, and I'm going to task you guys, if there's somebody out there that listens or watches that's partook in this, you can comment anonymously. I really want to know what you gain out of, I need to understand what you gain out of paying somebody for that ranking, when to me as a PvPer, that ranking is a personal achievement, right? That's like for me to say I got this, and I don't understand.
Sauce.
Is that to brag?
Sauce just made a good point, though. Like, shit, if I had the skills and someone offered me $200 to play a few rounds for them, you know what, son? I'd take that money.
But would you really?
So I can see the flip side of the coin. Like,
but would you really? Because I wouldn't.
Do you understand how poor I am?
I mean, that's what I'm going to get at. You would be
shocked to see what I would do, yeah, do for $200 right now. Like,
yeah, some PvPers, they don't work. Like, they live at home or whatever the case
is. How
about you get a fucking job? Is that so hard to ask?
And I get that. I really do. But at the same time, they're getting paid real-life currency for something that they really enjoy doing. Like, some of these PvPers are phenomenal.
It's the same thing. I don't like that you have to pay for guides. Like, there's people that sell guides on how to be better players. I don't know. Maybe I just have a different point of view.
I agree with your point of view. At the end of the day,
the business model in itself. Like, if people are stupid enough to pay for it, why wouldn't you take their money? Like, I'm not saying I agree with it, but I don't agree with that in itself is a business model. If you find something that people are willing to pay for, why the hell wouldn't you sell it?
I can see both sides. I mean, I can't imagine us ever putting, like, there's this thing on YouTube where as content creators, you can have it where people can pay extra money every month to sub to you. It's a different type of subscription. It's paid only content. So I have a problem with that because I'm not going to give somebody more because they paid me. I'm actually going to give them more because they didn't, right? Because I'm doing it for a specific purpose. Example, our Patreon. There's no reward set up for different stuff, or I don't do... I think we have like 92 people that are on our Patreon, $92 worth of people, which is awesome because that covers some costs for Pwncast. But on there specifically, I put, we're not going to do special content for those that put into the Patreon because I'm not bartering in that sense. Like, that's not
right. We're on two different topics now, right? So the question.
It goes along the same thing with, we're talking about business models. So we're in certain things to make money. I think. I'm trying not to knock people that do it because I don't want people to think that I'm knocking their way of life. I just feel like I agree with Blizzard's decision. I guess at the end of the day is where I'm going with this.
Because they're messing around with terms and conditions and they're not doing it themselves. As far as asking the people, why did they do it? You don't even need to ask them, and we can move on, because they're doing it to save time. If they don't have to play, you just don't have to do it. You get your instant gratification, and you have the extra money, or you have the means to pay for it. Right, but then they also have the title, the mount. I'm not approving it. I'm just saying we don't need to even talk to those people. Who cares about their comments,
what's
right?
What's sad is well, no, it's really just more personal understanding, right. I guess. But
well, that's it right there.
Here's what's funny. These guys right. that partook in this during their road to BlizzCon, you literally blew a whole ton of money that you could have possibly had. Now, here's the sad part. To what end did you do that? Because you engaged in this activity. People were going to know it wasn't really you at the end of the day, because your play in the finals or whatever isn't necessarily your...
Well, are they a sub, though, as well? So that was the whole thing when they brought it out.
Right? We don't even know what teams were affected.
Right, we don't. But we're saying, or I'm saying, if one of those crappy people got carried, they're not playing in the tournament. They'd be a sub or whatever. They try to hide those people. But I think what Bloke was saying, and I know you're different, right? So he's thinking about, if he had the skills, would he allow someone to pay him to do that? That's definitely different when you are that skilled and, you know, you're playing the game anyway, right? So Bell wouldn't, Bloke would consider it because he's already good at it. He could use the cash. So, you know, that's almost different than what we were originally talking about. But those people are just lazy.
Money and gaming in general, I think, is a subject that...
Money makes everything dirty.
I do feel like it does, right? I think that really is a good underlying point in the final to close out the subject, is I do think money does make everything dirty. And I think the original point of what we're doing in game, it gets lost in translation when it comes to stuff like that. And that's just my opinion. Doesn't make it right, doesn't make it wrong. I'm sure some of you
will. Right. Now, is this right or wrong because you are Bell making, liken, level up your pets? No money involved, but I think you are being forceful. Is that right? Let's get into that topic, Bell.
He offered, and second of all, there's a second. Out of the kindness of my heart, I bought him a very expensive bird. Because that's
but see, no real world currency changed hands for that.
Whoa! The leader. Oh, my.
No money exchange.
I'm just joking.
Yeah, see.
That was for no purpose of being ahead on ladders. That was so that I could. I forget what I was trying to do.
Well, there is.
Trying to PvP pet battle.
Right. But there are ladders. You are affecting people on the Warcraft. Pets.com.
That's the only thing that I didn't to partake in the exchanging of real life money for said pet battles.
You're fine, Belle. You're not going to be suspended or banned. I think everything's okay.
I'm not really, okay. I don't feel terrible about that. But to no end, that's also that. Actually, you made a good point for me, because I could go and buy a level 25 pet from the auction house. So
you sure can.
They're all do anything that wasn't already available via
in-game currency, though, so it's acceptable.
Yeah, it's. Right. I mean, they're all different topics we brought up there, right?
They were good topics, guys. Jim, you're the voice of something. It's not reason, but it's something.
It's like a mini troll, and like try to pretend like I'm not a troll, but then I was just like joking.
But
around.
I did, in truth, I did buy a lot of level 25 pets. I did pay the extra couple thousand gold for the level 25 because I didn't necessarily want to level them so much as I wanted to.
Don't you get achievements for leveling them?
I'm sure you do.
Some, yeah. And I'm giving them all away because I had two new friends come back to World of Warcraft.
You did?
Awesome. And, yeah, you know how some people quit? They're like, I quit WoW, and they'll just, like, give away all their gold, or they give away all their... This guy cleared out his gold and pets and gave them to me, and I'm like, you should just hang on to them. I kept them, sold some, but he came back, and I'm like, you know what? I want you to pet battle. Here you go. I remembered which ones, and he went right to his garrison and pet battled and did the dailies. It was kind of cool. Nice. Kind of neat.
So yeah. I'm sure by now everybody heard about the man charged with the shooting threats. I mean, this guy, there's a lot to it, and I did an article on the PDQ about it. We did a write-up about it, and it was actually in relation to Heroes of the Storm. So but it happened in chat where he was verbally assaulting these players via chat, and some of this was really... really awful in nature. Violence against children were mentioned in his statements to these players. He then proceeded to message Blizzard on Facebook and was like, I know your guys' address. I'm coming for all of you. So this guy, they started an investigation. And here's what I love about Blizzard. The second they realized something was not right, right? Like, they were like, okay, so clearly you're talking about some weird shit here. They began investigating, and in their investigation, they served a search warrant at the gentleman's home. They found all the fucking evidence they needed, because it's literally all in his, like, their tracking via Blizzard side, plus I think this had even continued maybe into some social media beyond just Blizzard. I think he might have also been harassing these players in real life. I'm not 100% sure on that, but he was charged. They asked him why he did it, and he said he was just trying to instill fear in people. And he's
another weirdo, and he probably got what he deserved.
Yeah, and he's in California. He's 28 years old, and if you have a chance, make sure you read it on the PDQ. But he literally threatened to shoot up headquarters with an AK-47. Like, holy this guy, shit. Yeah, he was pretty serious in his threats, and I think that this just stands to mean. I mean, sometimes it's okay for you to be a dick in trade chat, but you should really be.
I'm just gonna throw it out there. And this is the difference between the way our countries work. If someone said that in Australia, you'd be like, whatever, dickhead. But in America, it's a genuine, like, I was reading it thinking, oh, the fuck, like, even I'm sitting here thinking, man, this dude quite seriously could have actually gone down there and caused some serious mischief. Man, ain't no games worth that. Like, what? There's no reason whatsoever to get that worked up about it or whatever reason he had for doing it and still... Find another way. Like, go and buy a scary mask and still fear wearing a scary mask. Like,
crappy part is some of his threats gave them cause for concern in a serious manner because some of his were crimes against children, and they were very graphic. I didn't even type any of that up in the article. I did link in the article the PDF of the original court documentation, which will show statements from interviews and exactly what was said in chat. You guys are free to go to the PDQ and read it. But it was so bad I couldn't even quote any of it in the article because... You got to be insane. Really sick and twisted for some of that stuff that was said. And I realize that people get angry because I get angry, but at no point is any of my anger involving trying
to... I honestly believe that it wasn't a case so much of arresting him because he made the threats. I think it came across as they went and arrested him because quite clearly he needs a shitload more help than what he's getting. Yeah. And there's no way to do that without endangering other people. So... But it's scary times, man.
It is scary times. I think Blizzard handled it well, and I do feel I feel confident in Blizzard's ability to protect us. I think that just is a testament to Blizzard's diligence, and I for sure appreciate them doing what they do to keep people safe. So, yeah, good things. So, moving on from that awkward topic to something a little bit more pleasurable. In case you're all living under a rock somewhere, tomorrow is the day. What day is it tomorrow? Anyone?
Tomorrow's the 9th. It's my day off from work. And
Tuesday, yeah.
Ready.
Demon Hunters will be playable tomorrow. Demon Invasions, Dark Whispers, all the beautiful pre-Legion things that we have been excited and waiting for, those are tomorrow. I have an article being done. It should be posted by the time the show is over of your full guide to everything you need to know about what's going to be taking place. So it's a very robust pre-launch.
Should we make bets to see if noon is actually going to be valid?
Nope. Well, here's the thing. Last time I was like, well, guys, it probably won't be until 2, and then it was 9 o'clock in the morning. And
yeah,
like,
it was earlier. Oh. I get that, but this is more being implemented tomorrow. Yeah, you're wrong tomorrow, a lot, too. So.
The Demon Invasions is definitely going to be... Fuck you. The Demon Invasions is definitely going to be... it's going to be... It was difficult in beta. They struggled with the servers in beta, so that's going to be interesting. Now... Some important things to know about Demon Hunters. You're not going to... You're limited, right? So... Right. You're not going to be getting all your talents. You're not going to be able to use all your talents there. That's not going to be till Legion. They're basically just giving you a small preview of what you can do. You have to have
just
at least
the tip.
Maybe just a little bit more than the tip. Maybe. maybe half.
Oh, man, I just cottoned on. Fuck, I'm slow today.
So you have to have a level 70 in order to be able to create a Demon Hunter. That's important to note. If you don't have a level 70 because maybe you're new to WoW, I'm not judging you. You're just going to need to grind to level 70 so that you can play your Demon Hunter. Keep in mind, this is also for people who purchased the expansion. If you have not purchased the expansion, you cannot play a Demon Hunter yet. You'll have to wait until Legion is live. There's that.
That's this guy.
But that's good. Like, obviously, we're all excited as WoW players for this big change, and it's going to bring a lot of players back. I mentioned my two friends that came back as well, but I think people in general are just going to at least resub probably buy their expansion and try out Demon Hunters. So it's a good time.
I'm spewing. I have to wait till I actually go and pick up the collector's edition. But at the same time, I'm like, I'm not in a hurry for Demon Hunters. Give me all the other stuff. But with the 80 bajillion Demon Hunters that are going to be lagging the fuck out of my servers tomorrow,
I'm wondering what. Are you?
No, I haven't even made a DK, and that's been forever. So I'll probably give like three more expansions.
I don't know what kind of accent to put on my vowel. And which vowel to pick, the I or the A?
Vowel, all of them.
Juma Banks or Insane James. I don't know. What is my Demon Hunter going to be named?
Jimadin.
Jimadin.
I was just thinking the same thing.
That actually is pretty catchy.
It's either that or Illabanks.
Illabanks.
I think you're all on enveloping mists right now. You guys are a little messed up right now.
Here, I have the link. It should be ready in a second for you guys as far as what you can be looking forward to. All the good things and the bad things.
I'm going to go make both those names right now for you, Jim. Just so you know.
I go back. Every accent for Jimma Banks is gone. I'm like, damn it.
What did you decide on for Jim's? What did we say it was going to be?
You guys didn't decide anything. You made a bunch of suggestions.
Illabanks. Illabanks.
Appreciate the feedback.
Yeah,
Jimadin or Illabanks.
If you guys are wondering what's going on, I did post a link in chat. And you can also go to the PDQ. That Legion pre-launch guide is live for everything you're going to need to know, including the maps that are covered for the demon invasions and all those good things. And Dark Whispers, the whole nine. There's a lot of stuff that's going to be going on from now until Legion. There's the Broken Shore pre-quest line. There's a lot of crap that they've got throwing this way. So I think we're maybe just weeks away from
Christmas.
Like, no, I don't want to hear anybody bitching that there's a lack of content is really what I'm excited about, right? I'm excited for a time of peace in the land of now there's going to be so much stuff come August 30th that people are going to be complaining they don't have time, I think, to be able to do all the things in the cha-cha. So
I'm not keen on this piece. It's called World of Warcraft, not World of Peacecraft.
I'm excited, and I don't know about you guys, but I'm excited just because we've been in beta and I've got to see these beautiful lands and the beautiful maps and the thing. I know that people are gun shy because of Warlords of Draenor, but they really did a good job with Legion, guys. Like, they really did a good job.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not me like trying to suck up, because you guys know.
Oh, I forgot to mute my mic. I'm sorry. I was making those characters. My bad.
You're really making them right now?
I did. I made both of them. I made Jimadin and Illabanks.
Illabanks. Illabanks.
You guys suck.
Why? Why?
So that's pretty much... I'm trying to see if there was any... I don't think there was any other real news, because we have quite robust segments. So I am going to lead in before we get started on our segments. So last week, I did attempt my Spice Girls song. Now, it was suggested by Jimma that I pre-record, which worked out perfect because Ewok sent me a tank with balloons so I could fill up a balloon and it wasn't tied and I didn't have to fiddle with all that. And I actually got to record the song in sections so that I could put it all together. I still was a little lightheaded afterwards, but it wasn't that terrible. So today's song is actually, I had forgotten what I said I was going to do last week, so I did choose the Pokemon song, the
theme. Yay!
Song. Because I know that song, because I used to sing it. Yeah, I used to watch Pokemon, but anyway. So I did
gotta catch 'em all.
I did do a nice little. I put together a nice little video. I'm also going to be redoing the Spice Girls one into a video because I want to give everybody their due justice with their money because they gave good money for this. So for those of you who don't know why I've been singing these songs on Helium, anybody that backed the God tier for the DitchCon Kickstarter, which was $300, they got to choose a song for me to sing on Helium. So here's what was crappy. So when I was doing this Pokemon song, right? Hots for Shots knew I was doing it. He doesn't bring me the giant Pikachu until after I'm already done. And I was like, this guy could have been my wingman during the show. Here's Pikachu.
He's going to have to do it again. I wouldn't be touching that thing, man. I've heard stories about what happened to that Pikachu in his room.
What's the CP on that one?
That's scary, bloke.
I'm not saying nothing about nothing. You got gloves and a black light?
I do have a beautiful rendition of the Pokemon theme song. Now listen. For those of you who are going to make fun of me, just don't. Just tell me.
Just continue. Whoa.
Just tell me I did a good job. because I already
Bell, what do we promote?
Well, listen, you know what we promote? We promote Bell's husband, Dark, was being a jerk earlier about it. And then Hots was walking past when I was singing, and he was like, that is amazing. They're rude. But I'm going to go ahead and let you guys check this out. You guys probably want to watch the stream so that you can see the awesome song. But I'm going to let everybody get prepared, and then we're going to go ahead.
Oh,
and,
I'm watching the stream, all right. Oh, I'm ready.
Volume cranked.
I'm going to mute. I'm also going to mute you guys so that there's no problem. So
story of our lives.
Yep. It just is always.
Okay. All right. They're muted. So I'm going to go ahead and mute, and I'm going to let you guys enjoy this awesome Pokemon song.
Train them is my cause. I will travel across the land, searching far and wide. Teach Pokemon to understand the power that's inside. Gotta catch 'em all. I know it's my destiny. Oh, you're my best friend. A heart so true. Our courage will pull us through. You teach me and I'll teach you Pokemon. Every challenge along the way, with courage I will face. I will battle every day to claim my rightful place. Come with me, the time is right. There's no better team. Arm in arm we'll win the fight. It's always been. Gotta catch 'em all. I know it's my destiny. Oh, you're my best friend. In my world we must defend. Pokemon, our courage will pull us through. You teach me and I'll teach you Pokemon.
Perfect. Okay, so
that last note.
Oh, fuck my life.
That actually took me back in time in childhood, because when I would sit in front of the TV and I would sing that, I would literally sing that very last part like super duper loud. So I did give it my all. I hope that was $300 worth, and I hope it was totally worth it. That was courtesy of Cash, aka Matt, who is the one that picked that song. So hopefully you guys feel I did that
justice. Of course you would pick that fucking song.
I feel like it was a $300 song. I don't know about you guys, but...
You were in it to win it, too. That's the best part about it.
Belle, if you teach me, then I'll teach you.
So that is what happens when you allow me to have helium.
Like I said, I was very impressed with the power chord at the end with the, and you got the soul vibe going. So Pokemon!
The first time I did that was when Hots was walking past, and he literally was like, wow. So yeah.
It's not that crazy.
You might have a career after all.
So the other songs we have, I'm trying to think, I think I'm going to do Enrique Iglesias' Hero this next for next week's episode. I'm excited to do that.
Great.
Yeah, because I think that's going to be one that's pretty funny on Helium, because it's a super like touchy feely song. So expect.
Can you wear dude's clothes and like pepper in like a beard or something like an Enrique soft?
I did think about dressing the part. I did think about that, but we'll have to see how into it I can get. It's really difficult to do with my whole house. Like they stalk me when I do stuff like that. So I'm trying, if nobody's watching me, I can put more into it because.
Yeah, I'm like, still crying over it. Yeah. It was funny.
Well, I think adding audio to your videos, it'll just become more comfortable. And before you know it, you'll have like an 18 track CD soon.
I am posting that video, just the section of the Pokemon song. It's actually already up on YouTube. I just need to make it public. So you guys can feel free to share that for your laughing enjoyment.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, you guys.
Leave a comment.
My kids are gonna love that.
Yeah. Most definitely.
Caddy will love it. I know he'll appreciate, you know, my efforts that I put in. Now, for those of you who had the horror of watching last week's attempt, I am going to be redoing Chaos's the song, the Spice Girl song. I'm going to redo it and do it in this fashion to give that also its due justice.
I think when you redo it, you should be in your BlizzCon dress.
Yeah.
Well, the BlizzCon dress is being worn on stream, and I'm not wearing it more than once because I have to wear it to have breakfast with Stone because I did promise him I would wear it at breakfast as well, but I'm not wearing it outside of those two times. So
then you should do is wear real trashy makeup, like just stupid lipstick with rouge all over your face. Like, just overdo it.
That should be done. I'll probably be doing that stream with the dress right before, probably a couple days before Legion launches. Right now, all my time has been consumed by doing videos for the YouTube channel for Legion, so that needs to be where my time is, but it is on the agenda. I haven't forgotten about it, or I'm not doing it. It's just I have other priorities that need to get done first, so probably the week before or a couple days before will probably be when I do the stream with the dress.
I love how you get the impression of like, I'll wear the dress when like me and Stone have breakfast, and you sort of played it off like none of us will be there, or the, you know, there won't be a huge block going, come friends, come all.
Will you guys
see the bell in a dress in real life?
That would be awful if you do that.
He's probably going to say free breakfast at wherever you guys are eating and everyone goes there.
Would you really do that?
Oh, yeah.
Do what?
You would make everybody go?
Well,
remember all those times that you mute us on the Skypes before the show starts?
Well, Belle, you're looking at it the wrong way. We're promoting Pwncast. Any way we can get us out there?
Come have a photo with the Bells in a dress at breakfast.
Yeah, beautiful.
I'm a team player, so that's how we're going to roll.
And if that doesn't happen, I just bought a head strap from a GoPro, so you will get footage of it anyway.
Well, and pictures are worth 1,000 words, and you guys better snap all the pictures you can, because it'll be the one and only time that you see that kind of shit happening, because it just doesn't happen in my life. So
until next year.
I was just going to say that.
She's going to lose some other bet by next year.
That's
so
awful. You guys are just terrible individuals capitalizing on my discomfort.
That's right.
So.
What are you talking about? Your discomfort. Apparently, Ewoks decided I'm wearing Heather's wedding dress.
You wouldn't even fit a leg in Heather's wedding dress.
Well, it's going to look dead sexy then, isn't it? Yeah.
I don't want to see all that
stuff.
I
got to put my good underwear.
I do.
So now that we've all recovered from seeing that awesome helium stuff, the things I do, man. Literally, if anybody ever in my life ever questions my level of dedication for Pwncast, I'm probably going to set them on fire, because I think I've established that my dedication has no shame at all. So let's get into our segment, shall we? So I know that Bloke actually had, finally, he had a nice big, like, a lengthy post from somebody on the Pwncast Facebook page in regards to his Bloke's Bullshit segment. So I'm going to let Bloke take it away and go cover it.
Bloke just had to
go have a sandwich.
Remember to unmute Bloke self. this week, it actually came through last week. And I got a couple through, and they're all like really heartfelt stories of just demonstrating why we love this community as much as we do it. And this one came through from Dustin. So I'm literally, like I did last week, I'm just going to read it word for word as it came through via the email. So he sent this in via the Facebook and said, a few months after I started playing, probably around August of 2006, I was questing in Arathi Highlands. There were a bunch of elite, now known as group quests, there for strong guard keep. I asked in local chat for help, and a few people who also needed to do that quest teamed up with me, and we cleared the place out in about an hour. One of the people in the group, a night elf hunter, I ran into again for group quests in Tanaris. The next night, we decided to keep playing together and become friends. 10 years on, and many, 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 many characters later, we're still friends. He doesn't really play very much anymore, but we still regularly talk on Facebook. And though through him, I ended up in a family-ish type guild full of people that called each other by their real names. really tight knit and close, where many of us had each other's phone numbers and Facebooks and knew each other's family. Many of the family members even played at some point. Then one guy joined our guild a year or so after we did the majority of. That was a bit confusing. He thought a lot of people in the guild were a bit of a dick because there was sarcasm and smartassery and all the rest of it. But then when he was asking jokingly in guild for 4,000 gold, which back in Burning Crusade was a hell of a lot of money, to get his epic flight training to start his Netherwing quest, I offered it to him and lent it to him. He then realized that being a smartass and there were actually nice people in the guild as well. We too have kept in touch and over the years, and just a month ago I boarded an aeroplane for the first time and also for the first time went more than 100 miles across the country to meet with him and his friends in California. That's something I directly relate to. Like, Adelaide being the asshole of Australia is somewhat isolated in itself. So I was kind of shocked when I joined Knights of the Dark Age to find out that, like, there's a good proponent of the guild that actually live locally. And nearly 4 years, I'm like, holy crap, you people live in the same city. It's a big deal for people that are slightly more isolated. He goes on to say the same friends who were the backbone of Karazhan and Lich King 10-man raid groups, a lot of them turned into real life friends, and they had this trip together and it was really awesome. One of the husband and wife raid teams also had a kid while they were doing their raid progression. They raided with us and had a child that one night we were raiding in the Battle of Mount Hyjal. Their son is now like 8 years old, and I still remember fighting Rage Winterchill when their friend popped into vent and told us that he just got back from the hospital and wanted to let us all know that the baby was born and doing great. So there's that real family connection. I met so many nice people through this game. I try and pass it on where I can. I've flown people on my Sandstroke Drake to places they needed to go away. I run with people from Ironforge up to Western Plaguelands in the early days. I help people who seem to be struggling fight higher mobs and seem to be in jeopardy just because I can. If someone's asking for some old school mats and I have it in Guild Bank, I give it to them. I got so much gold that I don't need it, and I figure if it makes their day a little better, then that's good enough for me. Now, the whole reason that hit with me is because everything that Dustin's just sent to me there is what I'd love to see continue on in the game and come back to the game, in terms of he really got the essence of, like, you know, building that community and talking to the people that you're playing with and helping them out and doing stuff together, because it's why you turn into a sandstone drake and you're flying halfway across the map and you got someone on your back. You're not just flying along. Like, you're having a chat, you're talking about stuff while you're flying, and you're building those friendships, and not just in game, but with the actual people behind the character, so to speak. And the end result in that, and I've been very, very lucky in terms of BlizzCon, getting to meet a whole bunch of people that I played these games with for, you know, 10 odd years that have all lived in the state. So I understand that well and truly of the adventure and the sense. And when you get to know these people and they become your friends, they become your family. And that is what the social aspect of the game needs to become to sort of reclaim its glory. Keep sending me the stories, keep sending me the questions. Someone asked me about some computer parts and whether it's going to be able to handle Legion. And I found that pretty funny. And I have actually got on top of that, and I'll get to that next week, because it's definitely going to have a very bloke-tastic twist to it. But thanks, Dustin, for sending that in. I really enjoyed reading that story.
Those Netherwing Drakes, when I first saw them, were awesome. I know you mentioned that they farmed them or gave them the gold for them, but I definitely wanted to buy all of them.
I actually recently discovered that I'd actually missed one of them, so I went on a character that I hadn't even got close to getting them on, and did the whole quest line again and relived the adventure, because I remember back in BC it was like, this is going to take me forever, 10 years. Like, it was a big thing back then, and especially the 4,000 gold. So to be able to turn around and, in his case, turn around and you know, dish out 4,000 gold to a guildie, I mean, that's putting a lot of trust. But it's a shining example of, you know, if you got the money, help other people out. Like, if everyone helped everybody out just that little bit, like, it would make a massive impact on the game. And it's something that I feel pretty strongly about, that we need to really reclaim that and make you know, to steal the words of that guy, we need to make WoW great again.
Okay. We got yeah. a pretty good, our community with the guild is like that. They're very giving. I think it's nice.
Well, that's that's ultimately why I think everyone here is such a good fit, is because to me the writers and Knights of the Dark Age really uphold everything that I want to see come back in the game. It's very community orientated. It's very social. Everyone helps out. They got, you know, you've got that that interaction both in game and in other chat mediums and social medias and whatnot like that. So the community is alive and well with between the two guilds. Great. If only we could make that sort of, you know, more wide across the community.
Make it the rule, not the exception, right? Because it's at this point it's it's the small droplets among a sea of not happening that way. I agree.
Yeah, it's just hard though, because a lot of people are more concerned about themselves instead of, you know, doing for other people.
For sure. It's hard to get people in that mindset and to get them out of their,
you know, persistence pays off.
Yep. Agreed. I get mad when guildies don't tell me they don't have game time because I make extra WoW gold.
Oh, you actually get really pretty pissed about that.
It irritates me because we're a family and you should tell me these things. Everybody should game, right? If I could afford to buy everybody's World of Warcraft, I would. But
I'm almost out. I need a WoW token. Can you send me gold, please?
You are single and you have a job.
That was a test.
Yeah, he doesn't have a desk.
No, but
kicking you while you're down. You're not in love with anyone. You don't get a WoW token. What? Sorry, I'm trying.
Unless you have an animal that you're taking care of and that's where your money goes.
I get a puppy.
But yeah, I think that's a great segment, Bloke. I love that.
Well, thank you. I love it too, because I genuinely do. I really love reading the stories that people are sending me and the questions. Bod sent me another one that I'm hoping to sort of mix in with next week. So that was a really cool one to read as well. So
not only is it cool I didn't mean to interrupt, the stories themselves, but it sparks our own ideas. Like when you were talking about the Netherwing, I remember grinding out mine or whatever, right? So it's just like, it's good discussion. It's sometimes it's different than news, sure. Right?
I can't wait to see what other people sort of talk about and jog my memory, because in 11 years I've probably forgotten more of the dumb shit that's happened than.
I had to make a lot of room for song lyrics, so other stuff gets dumped so that I can remember songs on the fly. It's valid. I'm not
you
even
teach
joking.
Me and I'll
like,
teach
when somebody's
you.
Like, "Hey, do you remember that one time?" and I'm like, "Actually, I had to remember an Eminem song in order to be able to remember that. I had to ditch that one memory because that's the only way that works. That's just what happens when you get old, guys."
Uh-huh.
You only got a little head. It's max capacity.
I know. It really is.
We're like a sponge. Like, we absorb information, but the rest of the other water leaks out because it can only hold so much.
Valid. I don't know what that means, but I'm going to agree with you because you said it in a manner to which that you knew scientifically.
Once I did this,
that took it to a whole new level.
Yeah.
So I'm going to let you run with that. Leading into that, Gemma, what do you have for your segment this week?
Well, I've got a bunch of random information. Forget one topic. Let's talk about a bunch of random things. I like getting questions. You know, every once in a while we say comment, do this, do that. And we don't always get them. But Belle got a question from Kane on the iTunes questions or comments, right? So last week we were discussing, you know, how great I was at pep battles and how they're kind of easy.
I don't know if we were discussing that so much as you were discussing.
I was telling you. 100%, right. But so there's other people that are, you know, people who are, they don't pep battle as much. Pep battles can be intimidating. There's so much information, right? Blah, blah, blah. But then there's lifers like myself and other of you watching where you just, you know, the fights. And I was saying how some of the new pep battles, although very unique and creative, I like what Blizzard's done with a lot of the pep battles for Legion. Some of them for me are too easy. Now I've got a wide variety of pets. Not everyone does. So I was saying how maybe we should change the difficulty, right? We have our regular pet battle, and then maybe we can turn these rare pets that we're fighting against, or maybe a rare boss, because sometimes the name's in purple, let's bump it up to a legendary one, right? So Kane, nice guy, he asked, you know, I agree with Jim, of course you do. Maybe like the dungeon and raid system, pet trainers can be similar like that. So he said, select normal. Well, it's normal. Of course, you just do the regular battle. Heroic for more health, hits harder. Mythic as above, and possibly an extra move or an ability. What do I think? I'll tell you what I think. I think it's, I agree, but I don't think we should have three levels. Even when I was expanding on, you know, Blizzard bringing in rare pets and all these different ideas, I had to get all these ideas up here. Belle was also mentioning, you know, it's just one part of pep battle, so we can't make it too detailed. But so I don't think three difficulties is what we need. I think just the normal mode and maybe a harder legendary mode and maybe increase the rewards that you get, right? So I'm down with that. Kane, thank you for the question. My segment is sponsored by my YouTube channel, Warcraft Pep Battles. We just hit 6,000 subscribers, big milestone. Pwncast is quickly catching up as well, over 2,000. But I put a lot of work into these guides, you know, teaching you how to buy and sell companion pets, how to defeat these different trainers. And, you know, I show up every week and let you know how I'm doing and the different pet battle information. Not only should you subscribe to the Pwncast YouTube channel, come to Warcraft Pet Battles. Very easy to find. Picture of a sexy little molten corgi. Click subscribe. And I always respond to the questions and comments on Pwncast YouTube channel and my own. So I really wanted to just celebrate with no, you know, bells and whistles. Well, I got a bell here, no whistles.
Please.
Yes.
I know.
Well, is it his bell or his whistle?
Well, yeah. we've been trying to do an all man show for a while. You're right. 1 week without Belle, I don't think she'll approve it, guys. So we will have Belle here on a regular basis, right? She's part of everything, right?
Well, she's gonna come back next week with a fake mustache going on and be like, "I am Man Belle."
In 120 episodes, I have never missed an episode. So
right. Well, she may still have her Enrique 5 o'clock shadow still from recording that.
I'm gonna have to get some like black hair dye because he's. And I'm gonna. Oh no, that's the dad that has the mole, right? Or do they both have the mole? One of them has like a really awkward lip thing. Moly.
There's a thing called the internet. You could just look it up and find out.
But then NSA is gonna know that I've been googling Enrique Iglesias, and then
what the fuck?
And then it'll pop up in your Facebook feed.
And then I'll see it on Facebook pixel ads when I'm scrolling through Facebook, and I'm gonna be seeing his face everywhere.
Really yeah, cool. Pretty much.
I do have one more thing, though, guys. You know, I'm a talker, so I'm going to extend this segment. As much as I like to talk about myself, and yeah, that gets annoying at times, I have a friend who also is in the Pep Battle community, slowly growing. Her Facebook page is The Art of Justice. She does a lot of Warcraft art, a lot of personal photos as well. The reason why I'm bringing up The Art of Justice, she's been making these pictures of pets, sometimes two pets, very cute. And you print them off and you color them. So I think that's very unique. Yeah, yeah. Friend, you know, some of you have little kids. Some of you like to color. That's not the best setup, but, you know, coloring's fun sometimes. So, for instance, like she did an Unboar Valkyr. She just showed me the Mercadin, which is a cool pet that will be coming out. So you can go to her Twitter or her Facebook page and print these off. Great for the kids, yourself, you know.
If I could stop eating my crayons for long enough, I'd probably really enjoy that.
Right, yeah. I'm still trying to get the one that I stuck up my nose when I was five. So I'll leave the link in the YouTube comments, of course. And it's just The Art of Justice on Facebook. Fellow pet battle lover, fellow Canadian, actually, unnecessary information. But check her out. Great work. You'll have fun with some of the content she does. That's all I got for this week, though. Friends.
Friends? Other friends?
I amigos? I did my beanie thusly.
Did she pay you for that plug?
No, I was actually, you know, my mind is always thinking, right? And I'm like, what to talk about, right? Talk about yourself. I do that enough, right? And then, of course, she showed me the Mercadin picture. I go, why have I not said anything on the show about
this?
You're
confusing. So, no. I wasn't wanting to banter about it.
Yeah. No,
I don't care. I'm just kidding.
Long hair, don't
I
care?
I do, because I've got kids that'll
that's
probably
for
that
the keyboard
do.
Turning comment, fucker. So I do want you to know, so I know, you know, Jimma and I, we talk a lot about YouTube stuff because he's actually the reason I've been able to do so much on YouTube is because he really showed me the things that I needed to do to be able to reach people and help fill the gaps that people needed. But I gave him a goal of what I wanted our YouTube subs to be at by December, which I can tell you guys, because we're all family here. I want 5K YouTube subs by December, which I'm thinking that's if I continue to work diligently, we should be able to achieve that. But what he doesn't know is my secret goal is to surpass him in subs. That's like my secret goal, because then it will motivate him, right? Because people, when they work together, you have to motivate each other.
And this is true.
The back and forth and all that, that's... So that is my secret goal, is to surpass Gemma's pet battle.
Ooh.
Yeah, and it's a high goal, guys. I set the sights high on this one.
Well, you know how I'll respond to, like, well, mine's just pet battles, and I'm on the show, so it's my subscribers.
I totally want to make it, and I guess it's not really me per se because it is Pwncast, but that's like my personal I want Pwncast to have more subs than him, just so that I can say it once that it happened, right? Because it wouldn't be for long, because he's that type of jerk that would be like, oh, okay, I see you're passing me. Now I'm going to have to double my efforts.
I'll just buy 2,000 subscribers. No, I'm joking.
With in-game currency.
Yeah, he has a lot of it, so. I'll give you 1,000 gold to subscribe to my, you know.
So I guess that's more encouragement for everyone watching to share the YouTube channel and the different videos, right? To make me sad.
For sure, yeah. The more we could overthrow the government, the better. Just consider Jim a Donald Trump at this point, guys.
Oh no, that's awful. That's all bad.
Building a wall around Canada.
Doing
or?
A really good impression, but it's kind of weird because you look like Philip and Terrence from South Park instead.
I just fought it.
That wasn't even a Canadian joke, but it was pretty funny. Love it. Don't be offended because I said Canadian. It just is what it is.
Okay. Canada?
Yeah, that's I've always called it Canadian. Okay.
Yeah, I know. Me too.
So Sauce has an awesome segment that I think was also brought to you by Kane, I think. Question mark.
It was actually kind of brought on by you, since you kind of yelled at us to hurry up and get our segments in. So
I yell? I don't even yell, guys. I don't even know what he's
she
talking
yells via
about.
Via chat
you
on our phones.
Gauge whether or not somebody is yelling.
Bullshit.
Via chat.
I know you too well to know the faces you're making and stuff like that. So I did talk to a lot of people last week in regards to like our tryout, if you want to even call it that, for rating. Interesting, nonetheless. I did finally download some sort of rating logs this time. So the next time we do a run. I can actually see who's popping pots, who's not saying everything bad and that type of stuff. It wasn't as smooth as I anticipated, because there were a few people that I had never rated with. So at the end of the day, I just kind of want to see where people are at in terms of rating and whatnot, as well as, you know, I know with Legion coming out, a lot's not super changing, but there are some changes that are going to go on into these new raids that are coming out. You know, a lot of people are concerned about raid comps and raid sizes and stuff like that. And, you know, there's a lot of guilds that are based around just, you know, real life friends that live in the same neighborhood, go to the same school, work at the same job. Like how Bloke was talking, or Jimmy, you were talking about, you got some friends that come back to WoW. I have two coworkers that just logged back into WoW, and they've been gone since, you know, Lich King. And, you know, they're on Skullcrusher, even though Secret's going to be leaving. Secret's, probably next week, going to hop on the plane, you know, more likely a flight path, and head on to Argent Dawn. But yeah, I'm just, you know, for me, you know, with us being such a giant guild in Riders, you know, there's a ton of people that want to raid. There's a ton of
I've
people
been
that...
running your tunes in my guild for a really long time, so I'm super happy about that. Like,
yeah. At the end of the day, Forgotten Prophets, we've kind of talked a little bit about raiding and coming back and this, that, everything else, but you know, we have Shawas in chat, Galleon, one of our really good rogues. He's probably watching the show too. And it's just not, the life isn't there anymore. And, you know, real life happens. And, you know, Forgotten Prophets have been around since vanilla. And we've had a lot of the same guildies for, you know, over 10 years. And just, you know, for me, am I burnt out yet? No. Was I burnt out during Hellfire? Absolutely. Because it was just the grind. And, but yeah, going back to my segment, people are concerned. You know, they just want to have fun raiding, and they want to know, you know, what should we run? You know, what type of comps and stuff like that. And as of right now, I say don't worry about it, because, you know, a DK tank, a prot tank, I don't remember the spec for Demon Hunters. It might be amazing. What is it, Vengeance or something like that? Or Havoc? One of those.
It's Vengeance, yeah. Havoc's the DPS spec.
Yeah, so I say just, you know, keep an open mind in terms of comps, because who knows what the good heals are going to be. And depending on how difficult you make the raid is going to determine, you know, what you're going to need. And it's just like Hellfire Citadel, you know, it was best to have, you know, a four hunter comp depending on doing Archimonde on heroic, you know, because of the damn stupid infernals that are awful. But just be open to it. You know, Tyrion, an amazing prot warrior. He doesn't even need heals. Like, that's scary. You know, that's how it was for prop paladins, you know, before pre-patch. I could heal myself without any issues, but now I got to learn that rotation again. And
I think they've made you guys a little bit more. Didn't they make tanks a little bit more reliant on heals?
Paladins, so for sure. Tyrion, no. Like I said, he was third in heals by himself. So his absorbs were through the roof, and it was actually pretty scary. I don't know if they're going to end up dumbing that down a little bit, but he could probably survive on his own for a good amount of time without having to worry about heals. You know, kudos to him, because he knows what he's doing, and some of us that have prot warriors kind of just play around with the mechanics. But I just say be open in general right now, because some people are kind of did pre-patch for a little bit. Some people haven't really played around with it as much as they should have. And with the game coming out, you know, in less than a month now, that's just going to push people more towards, you know, where should I really be in terms of, you know, what character do I really want to play? Because right now it's kind of up in the air. And combat rogues, oh my God. Outlaw rogue looks so much fun, but, you know, who knows?
And if you're just a normal raiding guild, you shouldn't really focus on specs anyway, because you're just, you know, if you're a mythic, I get it a little more.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, but we're redefining that anyway. There's no set comp per se, because we're redefining that. It's all new. The class play is different. The comp is open to interpretation according to the raid leader and what fits. Because even standard comps fit better with different guilds. I know our setup has always been uniquely tailored to us and not so much
what everyone else is doing.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, because, I mean, like I said, we have such a huge roster of people that want to raid. Like, we have, you know, essentially the casual people, because they can't raid on the days we raid. And, you know, we have the more hardcore base and, you know, whatnot. And I just don't want people to have to, you know, bounce around. Like, as a raid lead, I'm open to that, because if we need a tank, I will tank. If we need a heal, I'll do it. If we need a DPS, I have no issue with it. And that's just how I work, because I want to do what's right for our progression team. Where there are some raid leads that are like, no, this is what I'm going to play. You figure it out. And it's just kind of hurts your group when it comes down to a situation like that. Like, and, you know, for the next part of my kind of longer segment than I anticipated, you know, just expect to wipe, guys. Like, unless you've been playing beta and you did alpha and you know what these places look like and you know the full-on mechanics and stuff like that, just be open to it, because it's going to happen. I mean, you know, as long as my thing about wiping, as long as you're progressing as you're wiping, it's totally okay. When you guys start, you know, you do an amazing first attempt and you guys start digressing real quick and real fast, I mean, there's what happened. And it's hard to point fingers when, you know, I'm trying to do everything I can to watch every single person in our group, especially when we have like 23, 25 man raid groups. It's impossible. And I'll get a ton of tells from multiple different angles, but it's just, I don't know if I should have an assistant, you know.
I was just going to say, do you have that? Because usually you usually have like one or two go-to guys where, like, so if you're a healer, you know, maybe the tank will be watching the other tank as far as that, or one of your DPS will watch, you know. I'm sure it's easier for you specifically to watch the healers as you're healing.
Yeah, I mean, I'm watching heals and I'm watching anyone that's within a good field of view, like all the casters and stuff like that. But for the most part, I'm just looking at the tanks and watching, you know, where they're standing and what they're doing in regards to that. But for DPS, you know, melee especially, I can't. All I'm worried about is them not dying. And it's something I really do need to consider, because it's so much to do. It's like I say, I raid every fucking Wednesday through Saturday at work. And, you know, my DPS at work is awful. And it's funny that I'm using this comparison again, because a lot of my coworkers laugh about it, because it's actually pretty valid. But I just, at the end of the day, guys, especially with Legion coming out, just be open. And that, and I use that a lot, and I'm going to say it a lot from now until we start raiding, just like everyone starts raiding. It's going to be fun, but at the same time, you got to take it for what it is. And as long as you're having fun and you're enjoying what you're doing and playing with the right people, it will work out. Just some people, I don't want you guys to pug as much as, you know, I've done it. I've had a lot of guildies do it. I've had a lot of people in writers do it, but it's not the same, you know. It's, you really can't mold anything out of that. And, you know, yeah, Bloke shaking your head, yeah. I mean, Shaw was one of my guildies in Forgotten, he pugged his life away, and it's, I mean, you're getting out of it what you're getting, and you're getting yelled at for following mechanics even though they're saying you're not doing it. And I'd say just be with the guild that, you know, that has promise and you enjoy being in, and
be happy.
That's where I'm at. Yeah, that's where I'm at. I'm on the show because of the guild. So thank you, GM.
I want to hear some secret sauce rage stories, though. I don't want you to be that passive guy.
Don't worry, there'll be plenty.
There'll be more than enough. Pretty soon.
You don't have to worry about that because that is a thing. So
maybe I should record my audio while I'm.
Yeah, that's going to be a thing. But there's going to be a lot of stuff that we're going to be leveraging for.
I'm pretty sure if we recorded the audio of the raids, our rating would go from like mature audiences to fuck, you need driver's license in three different countries to be allowed to listen to this.
We are going to be taking advantage and there'll be video guides to come for raiding as soon as I can get into some of that content in beta, which I'll be working on that in the next couple of weeks. But we've got a lot of stuff to help you guys out as well that'll be coming to the YouTube channel, so don't you worry about that. Now, guys, this week for Bell's Bites, we're going to talk about what? PvP, because that's what I do. I PvP. Now, I could sit here and I could plug all my stuff like Jimma does, or I could talk about raiding like Sauce does, or I could talk about bullshit like Bloke does. But these guys do it so much better, I don't have to do any of those things, so you and I could just have a conversation about PvP. So this week, while taking care of the spec PvP videos that I've been doing, small plug there, but not as good as Jimma's plugs, for sure. There was a couple things that I wanted to talk about in regards to the PvP talents and what to look forward to. Now, I know that they're visible already in-game. Obviously, you can hover over them. You can read what the talents are and stuff like that. The videos that I did were really for people who haven't subbed yet and don't plan on subbing until Legion, so they can kind of get their head wrapped around what they're looking for. So in doing these videos, one of the things that I had already tested in beta in some of the battlegrounds that I did was the CC defensive. So as PvPers, one of the things that we rely on is our trinket, right? That's we have to have our trinket because that can basically make or break whether or not we live or die if we have that trinket. So for your top set of talents in across all your characters, it's not different from spec to spec. The top row of all the PvP talents are exactly the same, and that's because it is the CC defensive. So for the medallion, I think that's going to be people's logical choice, right? You're just automatically going to make sure you have your trinket because that's what we do as PvPers. However, in doing some testing, one of the things I realized is there's two other choices. There's adaptation, which I didn't really fancy adaptation, but relentless talent is a choice instead of the medallion. And for relentless, it's all incoming CCs are on a 25% less duration versus having that trinket. And I want to tell you the difference in when you would want to use what. Arenas, you're going to have your trinket. You have to have it because you have to be able to control when you use your trinket, because it literally could cost you a game if you can't trinket, or if you didn't save your trinket for the proper time, whatever the case may be. However, for Battlegrounds, I actually felt like Relentless was really great for, especially me as a Destruction Warlock, I get CC'd a lot. The reason I get CC'd in RBGs is because they try to stop my Chaos Bolt and they try to shut down my fear. So in testing Relentless versus having my trinket, you figure if you're in an RBG, you're dealing with at minimum 10 other people on the other team, that there's constant CCs going in multiple directions. So if you use your one on-use trinket every 2 minutes, you're not really getting a lot out of that trinket versus having an overall 25% reduced duration of that CC. It actually did feel like I was in CC a lot less in doing the battleground testing that I did this last week. So that's kind of a little bit of food for thought, and I wanted you guys to kind of be thinking about that, because I think naturally we're just automatically going to choose the medallion because that's what we do. But I think for battlegrounds and RBGs, especially for a role such as a healer who gets CC'd a lot, I think that Relentless would actually be a better choice, and I think you might find that you enjoy it because of that reduced duration. That combined with I don't even know what I was going to say there. It sounded like it was going to be something amazing, and it turns out that it wasn't. But there was somewhere I was going with it, and I just can't remember. The DR on like fears, sharing DR like that with you have that combination with the 25% less duration for that full CC, you're going to see like a 1 second CC or a 2 second CC when it comes to that. So that I wanted to make sure that I mentioned to you guys because I thought that was really important on a PvP level. And Jimma, you PvP, so I think maybe you might also kind of feel like maybe that might also be something worthy of trying as far as...
Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. I didn't know that because I haven't done as much PvP, so it's great information. And you're right, scenarios, whether you queue into an arena or battleground, even for other talents, it's all situational, right? Comp. Sure. So it's good to know.
For sure, for sure. So I wanted to make sure you guys knew firsthand about that.
Thank you, Belle. I'm so looking forward to that part of my life.
Most appreciated. I'm very thankful for the information.
Bunch of dicks. So let's talk about dicks. A couple people had commented on the YouTube, which got my thought process going. Their comments were, well, really, the PvP talents don't even matter. Now, that unfortunately, those individuals were sadly misinformed because they in fact do matter, because I can tell you that if I have PvP talents and you don't, I'm definitely going to win. And the reason being is the different types of talents that you have. Some of these are really, really overpowered for some classes. Like, it literally will put you over the wall. You guys can go to the YouTube channel and see it, but you can see it on your own character, so it doesn't really matter. But they are going to matter. So let's talk about your acquiring of your mounts, your pets, and things like that. We had talked already about you're going to be getting those during your prestige. That's going to be when you're going to acquire those. Now, I don't have the actual prestige level that you need to be able to unlock the mount and the pet, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be the fourth level for the first season, because they did state with the first season right off the bat there'll be four prestige levels. Then with season two, they'll add more prestige levels to it. So my assumption would be that they would want you to probably prestige all the way, you know, all four levels to be able to acquire that mount. But there isn't anything solidified yet because the data mining isn't accurate. There's no accurate, like, if you do this prestige this many times, you get the mount. So it's important to note that if you're interested in things like the mount and the pet and stuff like that, you are going to need to prestige, which means you're going to go without your talents. Now, to that end, somebody asked, if you prestige and you get dropped down to your one talent, do you get to pick that talent? Negative, Ghost Rider, that pattern is full. That will be your medallion. Your medallion is your number. That's your first talent that you get. So when you prestige, that's going to be all that you get until you start reacquiring those talents. The cool thing about the honor talents when gaining that honor level is by the time you're honor level 10, you'll have unlocked a talent in each row because it goes by column, which is pretty nice. So by the time you're honor level 10, the second round when you prestige, you'll be able to utilize at least one in each row. So that gives you at least something to work with, right? It gives you kind of an idea of the way you want to go. Now, for the honor talents, I encourage you to do your homework and do your research prior to the first season, because some of these talents might seem like the obvious choice, right? There were a couple times during some of these videos where I was like, as somebody who goes against, like, say, a sub rogue, that would be really cool for them to have to be able to, you know, to be able to kill me. But then I realized, oh, well, then this also in this row, I might not want to discount that. Make sure that in addition to watching what others are doing, right, the professional PvPers and all those guys are going to make all these videos, they're going to tell you all the right things to do. Don't discount some of these talents just because you think you're locked into some rotation. We're treading new waters here. Even the pros are treading new waters because they're tasked with figuring out how to do these things on a professional level. So make sure that you guys are putting your due diligence into your homework and theory craft. Don't just Google and put stuff in there. Actually theory craft. Try different talents in different engagements. Try different talents and duels and decide what fits best for, because at the end of the day, it's your play style. It is what works best, but I'm not talking to pros here. I'm talking to guys that are just like me. They're in the thick of the PvP. They're not the guys that are top of the ladder. You're just like me. You just like to PvP, and you might not be super kill all the things all the time, but theorycraft a little bit. Have fun with your talents and don't just lock into one thing because you think that's what it should be. Just kind of throw some stuff around.
Can you change them though? Like, I know you said once you prestige, can you edit them eventually?
So,
or
so what happens is you're honor level 50, you have all your talents. Then you're like, cool, the prestige button's here. It's a giant shiny red. I'm going to click the button because that's what
push
we
the
do.
Button.
We
yeah.
Push the button. So then it's going to reset all your talents to where you have to reacquire them. You get your medallion as the base talent, and then you'll have to re-level up through honor levels to be able to get those talents. Now, at any time, you can edit them. You can do it right before a battle, and you can do it in a safe area. But if you're trying to do it like in a raid, you need to have one of the tomes. Somebody needs to have a tome so that you can swap out your talents. The crap part here, guys, is the fact that they took your dual spec away in the sense of having you get to choose what your second spec is. So I had two Destro specs because I have one set up for PvP differently than I have one for PvP or PvE. Now, somebody had said to me a while back when I complained about that, well, the PvP talents are the only thing you need to worry about and you don't use those in PvE. That's actually not valid. Some of the stuff with Destro, my regular talents will be swapped out in PvP as well to highlight the PvP talents. So it's kind of crappy that Blizzard took that away from me, where now when I swap from raiding with Sauce, I then have to get into the PvP mindset and I have to switch all my
crap around. I cannot wait for that day.
I was just going to say the good news is she might be kicked off the team sooner than later, so you won't have to switch back and forth. You can focus on PvP.
I've accrued, just to respond to you, I have played Demo in beta and I don't dislike it. I don't dislike it. I'm Destro'd for life. We all know that. It is what it is. But I'm always going to be.
Just joining in.
Sarcasm Central said, this is more informative than the Muppet playing Guild Wars 2. I was watching before this. Well, I'm happy to oblige. That I'm not sure if you're actually complimenting or if you're trolling. So I'm just gonna.
Anyway. When the Muppets came back, though, that was a good series.
It really was a good
on series. Topic, off so, topic.
Also, another thing, I'm about to post on the PDQ. I've been watching Holinka's forum post regarding the template for PvP. We've talked about this on several episodes, where one of the differences in Legion is their ability to be able to separate when they affect PvP and affect PvE. They now have a PvP template. This means the second you enter in a PvP engagement, your template kicks in. This is different stats. It highlights different things comparatively to what you need for PvP. Now, the cool thing about this is, and I've seen this just in the last week, they make changes every day to the PvP template to adjust for balancing, right? This has been actually really cool because in beta, the changes are able to be reflected really, really quickly because they're template. Now, the template right now works in duels and it works in arenas, skirmishes, battlegrounds. Currently for World PvP, I know that they were talking about wanting this to be a thing. I don't think it's actually something that's implemented right now as far as World PvP. I'll actually have to go and double check my facts on that. But with the template, keep in mind, when they make a huge change for PvE, you don't have to be frustrated anymore because it doesn't affect PvP anymore. And I know that we're naturally going to be looking at the hotfixes when we see class changes as PvPers. Rest assured, it doesn't affect PvP because it's completely separated now. So going into Legion, it's not going to be a blanket situation where one affects the other. It's completely separate. And I think that Blizzard deserves kudos for that because it's something we've been asking for a really long time, for that separation. Please don't punish me because your Shadow Priests are overpowered in raids, or, you know, one way or the other. So with the PvP being separated, some people had posted on the forums and said, Blizzard's killing PvP. I have to disagree, and I actually think they're doing quite the opposite. I think that they're taking steps to really secure the future for PvP. It might look kind of crappy right now because they're tuning. We still don't have our artifact weapon, so even right now in regular WoW, our classes are not as powerful, right? They're just, we're basic bitches right now because we haven't made it to Legion content. So I think they are taking steps, and I would just ask that we give them time, we give them solid feedback, we really put into it instead of just logging in and complaining. Maybe we could, you know, go run battlegrounds, go post on the forums and wait, lobby for change in the correct way so that we can help shape.
Start petitions.
I heard you like petitions, so I created a petition about your petition to petition my petition for your petition.
I said this a couple of shows ago. Anyone that says Blizzard is killing PvP, it was dead last life. Expansion. No, yeah. It was, you know, the lack of content to me is as dead as it was. So this is them reviving it. And Blizzard has done better every expansion, balancing. I mean, they weren't successful completely, but balancing the PvP and PvE gear. Of course, this is the next step, like Bell said, because they're separating the moves and the different talents. So each expansion, whether you like to say they did good or not, they've gotten better and getting closer. And hopefully this is the next step to just have it as, you know, as good as it's going to be. So I think the changes sound good, and people need to try it and test it.
So that was basically my stuff. When Legion is live, I will be taking to the people that I know have mastered the changes with their class for PvP, and I will be we'll be sitting down and doing PvE guides for all the specs and PvP guides for all the specs, and they are going to be our style, what it makes sense, and what's actually workable. Real players are actually going to be giving this information, people that live this every day, not just putting stuff in a talent calculator and hoping shit works out for the best. Like, this is going to be real content that's going to be coming as soon as... I want to wait till Legion's live, because I feel like doing that before just is bad. There's already guides out
there. There's going to be some fine-tuning as well.
Do you have to pay for that guide?
No, it's free of charge, guys. We're
awesome.
Giving away
the milk. It's free of real-world currency charge.
Yes.
We're giving away the milk for free, guys.
You're going to have to pay with bitcoins or something.
Wait, what are we giving away for free?
We're giving away the milk. So be patient with that. Be working
bags of milk?
I'll be working with a lot of people that I can trust to know their class, to provide really easy, it doesn't have to be complicated, good solid guides for both PvE and PvP, as well as raid strategies and stuff like that. We're putting in a lot of work to the YouTube channel to be more than just talking on a show once a week, and to really, really give back to helping everybody kind of have a different perspective. There's guides everywhere, guys. The YouTube is flooded with them. Every other day someone's making a guide. There's nothing wrong with having more information and a different perspective. So with that said, with your PvP stuff, if there's anything specifically that you guys are interested in me talking about for Bell's Bites leading into Legion, if there's something you want me to test, or if there's a subject matter you want me to talk about in regards to PvP, all you got to do is give a comment on the show, send an email, bell@pwncast.net. Message the Facebook, whichever way. I'm here for you guys to give you guys information, so don't hesitate to do.
And she's always at that desk too, so she will respond.
I know, I'm always at the desk. I have no life. So with that being said, I think we've had a really great and informative show. We had little baby bloke made an appearance.
Sure did.
Love that baby bloke.
We had Sauce in his amazing hat giving great tips. We had Jimma selling out and
promoting
himself and a random person.
Hope you got paid for that.
For the low price of $3.99. And you guys got to see Belle sing on Helium, the Pokemon song. So we have a lot of good stuff in the works. Make sure you guys check out PwnCastDailyQuest.com. Make sure you guys have that bookmarked. We do a lot of good stuff. I know Wowhead is the go-to for a lot of this stuff, guys. I have no... We can't data mine, so we can't do a lot of the stuff that they do. But our stuff is going to be a little bit more personal.
If Wowhead earned 100 points for all the cool shit they have on there, they lost 1,000
for the ads.
The one in particular not cool thing on there.
Yeah, so when we're going to leave them to the professional stuff such as data mining. We're just going to break it down in an easier to understand and more.
I don't think they're very professional.
Yeah, I try not to judge. So, but make sure you guys bookmark that. And yeah, I think that was a great show today, guys. And we are near the end of time to where the
husbands... I'm going to dye my hair blue and change my name to Manza. And just be everything that silly trollop isn't. That's my official decision right now.
Trollop.
Who even... What was the other statement that... willy-nilly. You can't just go acting willy-nilly.
Oh, yeah.
Guys.
That's right.
You can't be willy-nilly.
We especially don't like to chin wag too much.
So awkward. But we're going to go ahead and get
week
on
and wow?
Here.
No.
Oh, we did forget the weekend.
I only say that because there was the one show.
Because we had a longer show and the time was... Yeah. Okay.
Going into overtime,
I know,
folks.
I apologize, guys. What
put the families on hold. We got weeks and a while.
Okay, so, bloke, did you get any mounts this week in WoW?
Do store-bought ones count?
No.
No idea.
Yeah.
What'd you do this week?
Did you buy one?
No, I tried to do the whole recruiter friend with the account that my dad made. My dad made an account this week. That was the highlight of my week. And it was also the migraine of my week because my dad doesn't play computer games and my dad's first, well, he does, but solitaire. But his first attempt at playing anything other than solitaire was to start a level 1 human paladin. And then he's like, how do you kill the things? What does this button do? Why is that guy over there? Can I talk to him? What about this guy? No, Dad, that's a pig. Oh, can I go over here? Yes, use the keyboard. And that consumed about possibly somewhere between 98 to 1,000 hours of my week.
Like, awesome.
It certainly feels like it.
Did you connect the accounts, though, to get the refer a friend?
I'm not sure what's
the reason why on. I ask is I made the mistake. I created a second account to get one of the rewards, forgot to link them, overpaid for nothingness.
I'm not too sure how that's going to work because he started the account and then I gave him 2 months worth of gold to get his tokens. So now I'm kind of hoping that any day now I'll get the furry.
Yeah, it'll be when it's the end of the 60 days.
Stay strong, blokes.
Yeah, they don't give it to you. Even if you prepay, they don't give it to you until that full 60-day duration.
Well, I guess I shall be waiting.
Yeah, it's kind of crappy. You think you're going to get it, but you don't. I've done
that. And I'm paying a hefty price, man. Besides the actual in-game gold, not real-world gold, just want to point that out, I have to put up with my dad's interesting way of playing games.
Maybe we shouldn't touch the desk. We need to get... Listen, if anybody lives in Australia and knows how to get a stand for his microphone, can you send me an email and be like, hi, this shop here in Australia has a stand.
But is it the microphone? Isn't him just tapping his fingers?
It's, so it's because the microphone sits on his desk. He needs a stand for
it. It's because I have something in my hand.
That is not the reason. It is because the microphone sits on
his
desk.
Look, he came to say hello, and he's not happy about it.
Any kind of movement he has on the desk, the audio will pick up, and it hurts people's ears.
To be honest, that was someone on the other side of the desk trying to hand me a tiny bloke.
That was fingers.
Yeah, because I had to move the things out the way so the little tiny bloke could come see.
Jimmo, what did you do this weekend well?
I caught up with my old friends, current friends. They came back to the game, right? Always great. And I just wanted to mention, as much as I do promote myself and I seem like I'm not a humble guy, overall, I really am. I think that's just who I am overall, this... I just like how Pwncast is always, when they've decided to speak about other channels or shows, it's people that they see doing good for the community. So I've always been about the community for my channel. Like, it's called Warcraft Pet Battles for a reason. It's not even about me. I don't talk about myself. It's just the guides and the pets. So same with the Art of Justice, pretty pure for the community. So I brought those up for a reason. I hooked my friend up with a lot of those level 25 pets so we can get back into pet battling. I have been going and observing the auction house a lot. I know I keep saying how I'll have these guides and specific stuff, and he wants those guides right away as well because he wants to make gold on the auction house. So we'll have those soon, and I've just really been min-maxing my options, going all willy-nilly, trying to find the best deals to buy cheap, sell high, and I'll have some of those tips to share with you in the future. So... yeah, that was kind of my week in WoW.
I love how I trolled him so well that he felt the need to explain his self-promotion. I told him.
I'm already going to...
God, I'm so good. When you make him question himself, that's how you know your trolling is on point. That was seriously nice. Was for the keyboard turning. Somebody commented on the show and was like, I lost my shit when Jimma said something about Bell's keyboard turning.
Well, and your response was not, I mean, I like to delay everything and talk a lot, but your response was, do I pay your subscription? And when I say those things as well, no, but that's fair, because when I say those things, you don't want to tell a person how to play. And I think sometimes if you ask people to not keyboard turn or do certain things in games, doing it the right way may make them actually try it. So I do recommend trying it, Belle. You will be a lot better.
When you say keyboard turn, I don't even know what you mean. I have no idea. I don't move as a warlock. I don't move. I'm a turret.
That's why she dies in our raids.
You have to move, though. You're right. Because I was the same way.
My movement on the keyboard is when I have to strafe. If that's what you're talking about, I don't really understand what you mean by that.
Or you want to be able to, like, if you're switching targets and you want to turn real quick, you want to turn with your mouse, because if you're doing it with whether strafing or if you're just turning with D or A, it's just a slight millisecond.
Can we do a video for the channel about keyboard turning versus not keyboard turning?
My chaos bolt hurts just as much, okay? But well, in truth, I don't really move a whole lot for it to be, like...
So there you go, folks. If you ever want to beat Belle in PvP, just keep running around in circles because she won't be able to keep up with her keyboard turning skills.
Yeah, so like pushing a button is the same whether I click the mouse. So I don't really, I mean, it doesn't affect my gameplay. And I honestly, when people say that, I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about.
It does affect your gameplay, but not to the point where you're like struggling. You can still be a good player.
I could see if I was melee that being a problem, but
even ranged, I was ranged as well. I'm going to cut you off. I was a hunter.
Even ranged.
I grew up as a hunter. I just recently had to go through this whole finding himself as Jimma Banks, the monk in the guild. Yeah, I was a hunter for years, and I got ridiculed as well as a keyboard turner. I'm like, oh, who cares? And then eventually I just got it, and I was better in arena. So even as a ranged player, you're right. It doesn't always come into play, but there'll be just like that trinket, that millisecond. You could get the chaos bolt of the person behind you in, I call hard switch, to kill a target in arena or RBG. You can still do it, but the millisecond really will give you that edge as well. So more on that next show or another show. Or
there you go.
I'm getting yelled at later.
Honestly,
I'm just
really,
joking. I'm joking.
It's one of those things where it doesn't really affect me.
Like, she didn't care.
It doesn't. And when people, like if somebody has asked me that before, I don't. I mean, so what does it, whether I do
it? Oh, right. Exactly. So that's the thing. Right. No, it's exactly.
Yeah, but
faux life.
Well, I actually can move with my mouse because Hots for Shots yelled at me like a year ago when he noticed that and was like, why aren't you turning with your mouse? Well, you're not the fucking boss of me. Okay.
So maybe you are not keyboard turning because that's the thing. Or did you take his advice or no?
No, it's on my mouse now. He did that for me a year ago. That's why I was like, when I strafe on my keyboard. Yes. If that's what you meant.
Well, that's different. That's different. Maybe
from Overwatch players.
Yeah. So that's what I was like. Okay. So you don't mean strafing I'm supposed to do on my keyboard then. Right?
Yeah, right.
Really, I'm going to have to do a YouTube video about keyboard tuning.
We'll discuss
the huge one predicted.
You're unjustly accusing me of keyboard turning. Uh-oh. And this whole time I thought you meant my strafe because I can't put my strafe. Like, I use my right click to turn on my mouse.
Well, you run a 2,000 person guild, a website, and a podcast show. You should know the difference.
And her real life job.
If right. I'm strafing, I'm not keyboard turning. See? That's it. This discussion is done.
This will be my last show. I will be being replaced.
He's going to retire after this, guys?
No. Yeah. I'm in the dog.
Sauce, what did you do this week at WoW?
Got home from work every day and fished and got that exalted with the angler, so now I have that mount.
Oh, I'm so close.
I know. That's really it. I mean, I'm leveling a druid with my two coworkers from Amazon. Good stuff. One's like ahead of me because he's an ass and just plays when no one's online because he's one of those people. And yeah, Guardian Druid is actually really fun right now. Kind of regret not making it sooner, but it's like I said, I told myself I'd make a druid before I made a monk, but I already have a level 100 monk. Still don't have that DK, so that's why I'm saying like a demon hunter probably won't happen till, you know, whatever the hell the third expansion in the future is going to be. So that's really it, honestly. I haven't really tried to. I got two more of my trinkets, thank God. The 110 trinkets. Yeah, dropped off the first two bosses of my run thanks to some really cool friends of mine from Wayward Enforcers from Airy Peaks. And so yeah, they helped me out because I hate running mythic dungeons. Like, I can't do it. I can't run old content. I just gave up on all that stuff because at the end of the day, guys, I really don't have the time. My time is work, the show, and in say 2 months, it's going to be raiding. So, nice. Yeah.
Cool.
I'm happy. I have my mount. Got to be four bells. Nice.
Grats.
I this week did a lot of angler stuff every day. I'm fishing, just fishing away, hanging out with the guild. Lot in beta doing some more guide stuff. I took like a month off of doing videos and started getting back at that, but that's pretty much. And then DitchCon planning, guys, we've been killing it with the DitchCon stuff. We got buttons, we got t-shirts, we got shot glasses, we got playlists, we got so much stuff going on at the same time. It's like literally all happening at the same time. So we have a lot of things going on. So that's pretty much what I did in WoW. Is my focus is anglers, and then I think I'm going to get back to. I am going to do the Demon Hunter. I played in beta, and I don't melee, but I actually enjoyed playing the Demon Hunter because I had a quest to get. There was something I was doing, so I did. I enjoyed that, but not keyboard turning.
Not striping.
I mind F you too. You mind F me, I mind F you.
I can't stand him. One of these days I'm just gonna light him on fire at BlizzCon. But so make sure you guys go to PwnCastDailyQuest.com. See what we have going on there. Make sure you follow the PwnCast on Twitter. Somebody has the actual at PwnCast name and they're rude, and I've been trying to take it since we own it. We own it. Yeah. And I would really like that person to please give it to me because it's rude that they took it. But make sure you guys do all those followings. Now, also, I'm going to link here for Bloke stuff. He still has his Australian packs available. I did put that link in chat. It will also be in the link on the comments in the description section for YouTube and iTunes. So make sure you guys head on over there and get an Aussie pack. He's getting close to getting what
we're
he
getting
needs.
There. We're getting there very, very close to the target goal now. And just a quick shout out that someone in Germany got their packages before the people in America did.
Damn.
So, aha, America. I don't know how that worked out, but we sent them all on the same day. But yeah, no, we just need a couple more to get us across the line and everything will be peachy.
Is Germany closer to?
I don't know.
Well, depends. If you're one of the people that thinks Australia's next to England, then yes.
But we are way extended over time, and I have a husband who's giving me
overtime. Overtime.
Children quiet. So we are going to go ahead and get on out of here, guys. Make sure you show. Give us your comments, tell us all your things, do all the stuff, and thank you so much for giving us your hour every week. It is appreciated, and we are honored to be able to bestow upon you the awesome entertainment that PwnCast provides, and a little bit of fuckery too. But
we're going to
get on out of here, guys. Bye.
Word.
I haven't even seen
time. Over time.
Thank you for coming.
I
it was good to see you.
In like 6 months. That used to be your go-to.
Well, I only just found it because I unpacked the box.
There you go. Are you drinking Coca-Cola?
You mean
what podcast?
That thing?
Yes.
You don't have one of those? We all have one.
Yeah, I totally don't have one.